Nobody plays guitar like this guy.
Hey, are you ready to learn how to put wow factor into Marty Stuart's Now That's Country? Oh, come on in. I think you're going to like this one. I sure do. Okay, I think you're going to have a lot of fun playing this song, learning to play this song. Now, usually when I start my tutorials out, I show you all the chords that we're going to play, but this one is going to be a little bit different because this has so much random picking on the chord strings, and you're not really playing full chords on many of these. So I'm just going to kind of get into it, show you how to do it, and give you some of the wow factor riffs and fills and let you kind of play it. Now this may not be exactly the way he plays it. I've seen him play it several times and it's always a little bit different. So I'm gonna show you how to put that wow factor into this song so you can amaze your audiences, okay? Come on into the studio. I'm gonna show you how to do it. Okay, the first chord we're gonna start off with is a G, but you're not playing, these chords are not, usually when I show you these tutorials, I'll show you the full chords. Well, we're not playing really full chords on this, it's a little bit different, so let me just show you what you're doing. You form a G chord. Now, I believe he does it with a bar chord. I'm not gonna use a bar. I like to play as many open chords as I can, so I'm gonna go down here and I'm just gonna form a G chord, but I'm only gonna play the 6, 5, 4, and 3, and I'm not going to strum them, I'm going to mute them. So I'm using the palm of my hand, I'm resting them right there on my strings, and I'm giving it like that. Now if you notice up here, I'm also taking the pressure off of those strings. I'm not taking the fingers off, I'm just loosening that pressure off those strings when I'm muting, like that. Okay, so you got a little mute, and then he's gonna do this little action here like this. Okay, and all we're doing there, I'm taking my pinky and I'm going across the 5th fret of the 4, 3, and 2 strings. And all I'm doing a pull off. And I'm hitting the same strings, 4, 3, 2, on the 3rd fret with my index finger. Now here's what's critical. As soon as you do that pull off, you want to get that thumb over on the 3rd fret of the 6th string and get those bass notes back in there, okay? So it's like this. Okay? Hear it? Okay, then you got another pull off. And all I'm doing there, I'm upstroking on that, on those 3rd fret strings. Two upstrokes, and those strings are open. Those are all open strings, but at the same time, I'm trying to hit that G chord with those 5, 6, 5, 4, 3. So it's like this. Now if you notice, sometimes I'm sliding down real quick and I'm using my pinky to hit that upstroke. That's because for me, I always like to think ahead. What's going to be the easiest formation of fingers to hit those next two chords? And for me, it's easier if I go with my pinky to that G than it is. But whatever's good for you, just get that, get back to that G real quick, okay? And then what he's going to do, he's going to do a little bit of a riff here. And it goes like this. You're going to take your middle finger and you're going to do a slide on the 3rd string. go from the second to four, and then take your index finger and pick up the second string third fret, like that. Okay? And then you do, with your index finger, get across the third fret of the first and second string, and you're doing this. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. You just keep hitting those strings. One. Okay. One, two, three, four. And then you're going to do a little slide. You're going to take your ring finger and you're going to put it on your... I'm going to on that third string, fifth fret, and I'm sliding up to the seventh fret, and at the same time, I'm taking my middle finger, and I'm getting it on the fourth fret of the second string. And three times, I'm going to do that little slide. And just go down one fret when you do that slide. That's all you need to do. One, two, three. Two, three, dee dee da dum, da 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 dum. Okay? And all you're doing there, you got your ring finger on the seventh fret of three. Slide down to fifth fret. Pull off. Get your index finger one on three. And then use your ring finger again to get the fifth fret of the fourth string. That's the next little riff. And all you're doing there, I'm doing there is I'm sliding with my ring finger from third to five. You can either go down to your index finger or you can just slide down. Okay, and then the next chord pattern, I'm going to go up to a B flat with playing it like an F, F formation, F chord formation on the sixth fret, which is a B flat, and I'm just picking some A flat to a G, so it's like this. A flat, do that little riff again. And then I'm going up to a C. Okay? And then I'm going to do this chord. I'm going to put a diagram up there for you. Whoops. Let's see B. Go back down to that riff. And then to get into the verses, he's doing a little walk up on that sixth string like this. Okay? So it's... Okay? Just a little walk. And then he starts singing. Da, 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 da. And you do that little riff right there. Okay, he does the verse again a second time, and he does that chorus a second time. And then he walks up to that bridge with an open 5, 1 on 5, 2 on 5, 3 on 5. And then he goes to that chord right there.
and they go.
And he does this little riff. So we, when you play that chord, there's your second chord right there. Da 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 da. And all you're doing there, I'm taking my index finger and I'm going across the fourth and the third string on that fifth fret. All it is, that's the sound you want. So you're 3 on 6. And I'm taking my index finger and I'm going across the fourth and the third string just for that one note. And that, all I'm doing there is I'm pulling off using my index finger, 3 on 4. And there's a little hammer. I'm going to the third fret on the fifth string, using my ring finger to pick the fifth fret of the fifth string. And my index finger is back on 3 on 4, like that. And there's the sixth string third fret. Then he does a little change. He goes up to a, now you're doing the same pattern, but you're starting on the fifth string. So when you do this, you're on, your index is on the third string and the second string fifth fret. And all you've done is moved it up one, and then you're back to that original progression. Okay, then you're back up to that F chord formation with a B flat. And that's the whole song, just those little riffs throughout the entire song. So note, that's kind of hard for me to teach that when I don't have regular chords, but hopefully if you know the song, and you're going to have to know the song to really understand what I'm doing there, but if you know the song, I think you'll be able to pick out those notes and those riffs like that. So hope you enjoyed that one, and I'll see you in the next video.
Subscribe now.